Welcome to the Shikasa Boo Motor Channel. This channel provides easy-to-understand explanations of car mechanisms. The Tesla Model S can accelerate from a standstill to 100 km per hour in just 3.2 seconds, even in the standard model. The Plaid model does it in just 2.1 seconds. It delivers a maximum system output of 750 kilowatts and 1,420 newton-meters of torque. The Porsche 911 Turbo S accelerates from 0 to 100 km per hour in 2.7 seconds. It has a maximum output of 478 kilowatts and 800 newton-meters of torque. Its price is about twice that of the Model 3 Plaid. These graphs show the power characteristics of the Porsche 911 Turbo S and the Tesla Model S. The Porsche graph is taken from the official website, but the Tesla graph has an unknown source, so it's unclear which generation it represents. Furthermore, the horizontal axis of the Porsche graph represents engine speed, while the Tesla graph uses vehicle speed, so they cannot be directly compared. However, they are sufficient to understand how different the power characteristics are. The standard Tesla Model S is equipped with two electric motors, while the Plaid model has three. Since Tesla's electric motor can deliver near maximum torque all the way up to 100 km per hour, while the Porsche's engine reaches peak torque at 2,500 RPM, the Porsche is inevitably at a disadvantage. Furthermore, the Porsche hits 62 km per hour at 6,750 revolutions per minute in first gear, requiring a shift to second. Even if Porsche's PDK completes a gear change in just 0.2 seconds, losing 0.2 seconds out of a 3-second sprint is critical. While acceleration alone doesn't define a true sports car, a long-established sports car manufacturer cannot afford to ignore it. Then the engineers at the established manufacturer had an idea: why don't we just add an electric motor too? The Ferrari SF90 Stradale, unveiled in 2019, is Ferrari's first plug-in hybrid vehicle. It features an electric motor positioned between the mid-mounted engine and transmission, driving the rear wheels. Each of the front wheels is equipped with an electric motor, producing a maximum output of 99 kilowatts and a peak torque of 85 newton-meters. In EV mode, the engine is shut off, and the vehicle is driven using only the front electric motors. So, in this mode, Ferrari SF90 is a front-wheel drive car. The battery has a capacity of 7.9 kilowatt-hours and is said to allow for approximately 25 kilometers of driving on electric power alone. The front motor control system is named RAC-E, cornering angle regulator, electric, and provides torque vectoring functionality by varying the driving force of the left and right motors during cornering. The engine is a 3,990cc V8 twin-turbocharged, produces 574 kilowatt and 800 newton-meter of torque. By the way, do you know what sets Ferrari's V8 engine apart from other V8 engines? It's the crankpin configuration. In a typical V8 engine, the crankpins are arranged in a cross pattern, a configuration known as a cross-plane crankshaft. Ferrari's V8 engine has a 180-degree crankpin phasing and is known as a flat-plane crankshaft. Compared to a cross-plane, a flat-plane crankshaft has poorer vibration characteristics, but it produces a beautiful exhaust note. Compare the sounds. The engines rotate at 20 revolutions per minute. The flat-plane crankshaft has even 90-degree firing intervals. With a cross-plane crankshaft, the engine as a whole fires at even intervals, but the firing intervals are uneven within each cylinder bank. Since it's hard to understand with this animation, we'll represent the combustion sound of the left bank with a piano and the right bank with a guitar. Next, we will compare the engine sounds created using the engine simulator. This software lets us simulate engine sounds under various conditions. If you're interested, check the link in the description. The two engines are set up identically, except for the firing order and exhaust pulse characteristics. While sound preferences are subjective, it's clear that the flat plane engine produces a more balanced tone. The rear electric motor is a double rotor, single stator type, axial flux motor. An electric motor consists of a rotor containing permanent magnets and a coil wound iron core. A typical motor is a radial flux motor, in which the iron core is arranged in a radial configuration. An axial flux motor has its iron core arranged parallel to the rotor. An axial flux motor delivers higher power than a radial flux motor of the same diameter and length for two reasons. The first reason is that the area of interaction between the permanent magnets and the coils is larger in an axial flux motor. The second reason is that the point of magnetic force application in an axial flux motor is located farther from the axis of rotation, allowing it to generate greater torque. The rear motor of the SF90 produces a maximum output of 150 kW and a peak torque of 266 Nm. The transmission is an 8-speed DCT, dual-clutch transmission. It's a bit surprising, but this transmission doesn't have a reverse gear. Reverse is achieved by rotating the front electric motor in the opposite direction. The system, consisting of the V8 engine, one rear motor, and two front motors, delivers a total output of 735 kW and accelerates from 0 to 100 km per hour in 2.5 seconds. The 296 GTB is a PHEV with a V6 engine, unveiled in 2021. It's a mid-engine, rear-wheel drive car without a front electric motor. An engine disengagement clutch and an electric motor are positioned between the engine and the transmission. In EV mode, the clutch is disengaged, and the vehicle is driven using only the drive motor. The battery has a capacity of 7.45 kWh, allowing for approximately 25 kilometers of electric-only driving. The V6 engine has a displacement of 2,992 cc, a V-angle of 120 degrees, and is twin-turbocharged. It delivers a maximum output of 488 kW and a peak torque of 740 Nm. The 120-degree V6 engine has the characteristic of enabling even firing intervals while sharing crankpins between opposing cylinders. We will compare the exhaust sounds of a 120-degree V6 and a 90-degree V6 with uneven firing intervals. It is clear why Ferrari chose this cylinder configuration. Also, because it has a low overall height and a low center of gravity, it positively affects the vehicle's handling performance. Additionally, Ferrari adopts a so-called hot V-turbo setup by placing the turbochargers inside the V-bank, which further lowers the engine's mounting position. Ferrari calls the engine disengagement clutch the TMA, Transition Manager Actuator. The drive motor, like the SF90, is a double-rotor, single-stator axial flux motor with a maximum output of 122 kilowatts and a peak torque of 315 newton-meters. The transmission is an 8-speed DCT without a reverse gear. When reversing, the TMA is disengaged and the drive motor is rotated in reverse. The system's total maximum output is 610 kilowatts, and it accelerates from 0 to 100 kilometers per hour in 2.9 seconds. The Porsche 911 Type 992, which has been on the market since 2019, received a minor update in 2024, with a hybrid model added to the lineup. The 911 Carrera GTS has been equipped with a two-motor hybrid system that Porsche calls the T-Hybrid. The single-turbocharged flat-six engine has a displacement of 3,591 cc, producing a maximum output of 357 kilowatts and a peak torque of 570 newton-meters. 41 kilowatts electric motor is mounted between the engine and the transmission. The engine and motor are directly connected, making it a self-charging hybrid that cannot run on the electric motor alone. This system is a two-motor hybrid. So, where is the other motor? Here it is. In the Porsche T-Hybrid system, an 11 kilowatts electric motor is integrated into the turbocharger's turbine compressor shaft. At low engine speeds, the motor increases the compressor's rotational speed, helping to boost pressure more quickly. A similar system is also used by AMG, and Audi uses an electric supercharger that resembles a turbocharger in shape. Unlike these systems, the Porsche T-Hybrid operates the motor as a generator under light loads or other conditions where boost pressure is not required, allowing it to charge the battery. Just like regenerative braking in electrified vehicles, recovers and reuses the vehicle's kinetic energy. The T-Hybrid recovers and reuses the energy from exhaust gases. The system's maximum output is 398 kilowatts, with a peak torque of 610 newton-meters. It accelerates from 0 to 100 kilometers per hour in 3.0 seconds. Although there is still a gap compared to the Tesla Model S's 2.1 second time, if an enhanced T-hybrid system is introduced in models like the 911 Turbo or GT3 in the near future, that gap will undoubtedly narrow. Thank you for watching. If you enjoyed this video, please consider subscribing to the channel. We'll see you in the next video.